This video is to allow you to correct your homework for section 4.1.1. So for 4.7, it says Croaky now has a new routine that's 59 feet long. Keep that distance in mind as we complete parts A and B. In his new routine, Croaky makes 7 super jumps, which are all the same length, and then hops 3 feet. How long is each super jump? So one way you could think of it is 7 super jumps, represented by S for super jump, because we don't know how long those are, plus the 3 extra feet that he hops, has to equal a total of 59 feet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, plus the 3. Now, another way you could write that is 7 times the length of the super jump, plus 3 equals 59. You could also think of that as 7 times the super jump equals then 56, meaning if we take 3 away from both sides. That would maybe help make it clear that each super jump must be 8 feet. If you want to draw or indicate how you got it in another way, that's absolutely fine. If X represents the length of 1 super jump and 2X represents the length of 2 super jumps, write an expression that represents his routine. Well, we've kind of already done that, except they want us to use a specific variable. They want us to use X for the length of the super jump. So 2X plus 2X plus 2X plus X plus 3 would work. 7X plus 3 would work. And of course, we could also even do it as X plus 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 3. Notice that we don't put what it equals because they wanted an expression and not an equation. Now Croaky can do a super high jump. The first time he performed his new super high jump, he did 3 super high jumps and then hopped 5 feet. The second time he did 2 super high jumps and then hopped 6 feet. Both times he covered the same distance. So what we're saying is the super high jump plus the same plus 5 needs to equal the same as a super high jump plus a super high jump plus 6. So we need to somehow figure out what if we have X plus X plus X plus 5, and that's going to equal X plus X plus 6, what does X have to be? Another way you could think of that is 3X plus 5 has to equal 2X plus 6. Now, you could guess and test at this point to your answer. Another way you could do it is you could say, all right, I'm going to take away 5 from both sides. Then I'd be left with just 3x on this side and 2x plus 1 here. So 3x would equal 2x plus 1. So the question is, what does the value of x have to be? And it is 1 foot, because 3 times 1 would equal 2 times 1 plus 1. How long is the whole routine? So now we're saying basically, if x equals 1, how long is the first attempt, which should be the same length as the second attempt? So 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 5 would be a total of 8 feet. That would also be the same for the second, 1 plus 1 plus 6. Here they want you to draw a picture or show how you know that your answer makes sense. So for A, 5 plus negative 4, you could show that on a number line. Starting at 5, going back 4 units, this would be a length of 1. 1 plus 12 and 65 hundredths would give you 13 and 65 hundredths. Here you could do it by saying, what is 6 and 5 tenths plus 10 and 5 tenths? Make sure you show your work. That would equal 17, but what if we add to that a negative 2, which means going back 2 units from 17, we'll be at 15. So again, show it on a number line or show your work somehow. Here, negative 5 plus 100 would be 95. 4 times 95 would give us 380. Here, we're combining 2 negatives. So if you're at negative 212 and you go back another negative 102, you end up at negative 314. Here, we need to make sure we're following order of operations. 5 and a half minus 1 is 4 and a half. 2 times 4 and a half is 9. Then we'd have 4 plus 18 plus 9. Again, show your steps. Having just the answer would not be adequate. And the same thing here. I should see your steps. Multiply here, multiply here, and then do the addition subtraction at the end. So again, just having these answers will not give you credit. Here we want to see long division. So we're going to want to see 683 divided by 4. So 4 will go into 600 approximately one time, or 100 and some times. 1 times 4 gives us 4. Subtract, we get 2. Bring down the 8. 4 will go into 28, exactly 7 times. Given this 28, subtract, we get 0. Bring down the 3. And 4 won't go into 3, so we put up a 0. Remember, anytime you bring something down, you need to put something up. So 4 doesn't go into 3, so we put up a 0. But since they don't want the answer as a mixed number, we're going to need to add a decimal point here and up in our quotient. And then we can add an extra non-essential 0, because 683 and 0 tenths is the same as 683. So we now have 4 going into 30, which is again 7 times, giving us 28. Subtract, we get 2. Bring down another 0. And 4 goes into 25 times. So this is the work we want to see on these. You can do it with your drawing tool, or you can do it in your notebook and take a picture. Same concept for this. I want to see the work in this same format. Now here you end up finding that you get a repeating 5. So once you've seen that pattern, you can put that down and you don't have to continue, obviously, until you get a remainder of 0, because it's not going to give you a remainder of 0. It's going to have a repeating decimal. Here they want you to rewrite them as a fraction, or if it's a fraction, rewrite it as a decimal. So we need to think about how we say this with place value. This is the tenths, hundredths, thousandths. So this is 7 thousandths. This is 103 with the 3 landing in the thousandths place. So 103 thousandths. This is 1 and 21 hundredths. And if we make that a fraction greater than 1, it'd be 121 hundredths. Here, 505 thousandths means that last 5 needs to land in the thousandths place. 505 hundredths, we can tell that's greater than 1, so that'd be the same as 5 and 5 hundredths. Should look like that. And 2 looks like 100,000 means the 2 has to be in the 100,000th place. So we've got tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths, 100,000ths. 2 goes there, and we need those zeros as place markers.